Meditation 3. Death can come at any time. Purpose. To know that we could die at any time. Key phrase. Again and again, reflect on the many causes of death. Death can come in many ways. Walk through a typical day and observe how many ways you could die. Take an inventory of your home and your work, and observe how many objects could cause your death. Death can come at any time. Is there a time when it would be impossible to die? Death cannot be prevented. Is there anything in your body that prevents you from dying? From Shantideva. First, open this heap of skin with your intellect. Then separate the flesh from the bones with the scalpel of awareness. Open the bones and look into the marrow and see for yourself whether there is anything solid. Can wealth, possessions, friends, or abilities prevent you from dying? Again, from Shantideva. There is no one to whom we can turn for help. And from Kala Rinpoche. We cannot defeat death, nor outrun it, nor argue with it, nor seduce it. Commentary. The third meditation has two sections, reflecting on the guidelines and sitting with the fragility of life. Spend 2 to 4 weeks working with the guidelines until you clearly appreciate that death can come at any time. Then spend another 2 weeks sitting with the fragility of life. A prevailing sentiment in today's world is that we all have a right to live out our full life. An unspoken but pervasive myth in many religious traditions is that if we live properly, we will be rewarded with a long life. The platforms of many political parties say that as human beings, we deserve a long and healthy life. Rights, rewards, and deserving have nothing to do with life and death. Life is fragile. Good people die unexpectedly, just as bad people do. Anyone who watches the coming and going of the breath knows that life and breath are synonymous. When the breath stops, so do you. We can no more invoke a right to life than we can waive a right to die. Death is present everywhere in life, despite the elaborate protections society and people put in place to establish a death-free environment. See how death lurks around every corner as you walk through a typical day. You wake up, and as you swing your legs over the side of the bed, your feet tangle in the sheets. You trip, strike your head against the dresser, shatter your skull, and lie dying on your bedroom floor. Maybe you escape that fate and walk to the bathroom. The pipes are old and leaky. Raw sewage has infiltrated the tap water you use to brush your teeth. Death has entered your body. Perhaps you slip in the shower and crack your skull open, or are electrocuted by the electric razor or hairdryer. You step into the kitchen, where knives, electricity, gas, and bacteria are all ready to do you in. Having made it through the lethal obstacle course of your own home, you leave for work. The steps are wet and icy, so you slip and fall. Once in your car, your odds of arriving at work go down sharply. Fatal traffic accidents happen every day. You've just been lucky so far. Continue through your day, noting all the different ways you can die in each moment. You don't have to be especially creative. Look closely, and you will see that death lurks everywhere. Go through your home, noticing all the cutlery and plates, cooking utensils, electrical and mechanical equipment, cleaning solvents and other chemicals, objet d'art, pictures in heavy frames, and other objects that could be the cause of your death. Stand on the sidewalk of a busy street. One step, one bump, and you die. Despite the precautions taken against food contamination, you are never completely safe. The canned tuna you have for lunch may be the last thing you will ever eat. Companies often recall large quantities of improperly processed meat. Death can come at any moment. Can you think of a time and place when you absolutely would not die? A hospital? Think of all the different kinds of bacteria and viruses, not to mention errors in surgery or medication. Your own home? You've already seen that it's a death trap. Out in nature? You could die from lightning, earthquakes, tidal waves, volcanoes, falling rocks, falling branches, or snake or insect bites. Where and when are you completely safe from death? The cartoonist Gon Wilson once drew a cartoon of a middle-aged woman staring at a man's hat crushed by a meteor. The caption read, "Harry always said that a meteor would get him." Is there anything in your body that prevents you from dying right now? The body is a complex organism in which even a tiny dysfunction can quickly lead to death. Can your wealth, friends, or abilities prevent you from dying at any given moment? Outside formal practice, continue to cultivate awareness of how close death is all the time. Imagine that death walks just behind you as you go through your day. Imagine that you feel death's breath as you talk with people, do your work, drive your car, walk to your home, go to a movie, or make love. At night, when you go to sleep, imagine that you are actually dying. Your life is over. You are not going to wake up. Anything can happen. It's not certain which will come first, tomorrow or the next world. When you sit in meditation, imagine that every breath you take is your last. Sitting with the fragility of life. As the possibility of dying at any moment sinks in, the first impulse is to shut it out so that you don't have to face uncertainty, fear, and discomfort. Instead, use the breath as a base of attention and experience the uncertainty, fear, and discomfort in attention. Sit with the question, "I could die at any time. How do I feel about that?" As in the previous practice, don't analyze or reason, simply open to the emotional impact of the fragility of life. An obsession with safety makes people impotent in the face of threatening situations, conflicts, or difficulties. In other words, the fear of death weakens your connection with power. The Stoics valued what could not be taken by another person. Since one's life can be taken by another, they didn't regard life as the highest value and were prepared to give their lives for what did have value. What has value for you? You can die at any moment. Expending energy to be completely safe is, in the end, a waste. Better to direct energy into being prepared to die at any moment. Are you prepared to die right now? What have you left unsaid or undone in your important relationships? What debts, obligations, or responsibilities have you not fulfilled? What do you need to do to make your life complete in each moment? These are the important questions of life that this practice brings to the fore. The two central facts of human experience are that we are going to die and that we don't know when. We generally ignore these facts and go about life in a quasi-dream state. If you wish to be present in life, however, to enter into the mystery of life itself, you cannot ignore them. You have to face the question of how to live with the absolute certainty of death and the complete uncertainty of life. On the one hand, you know that nothing lasts forever, that every relationship will end, and that the time will come when you have to leave everything you know behind. What is important to you? What is worthy of attention? What are you willing to live and die for? On the other hand, you don't know when you will die. Relationships can end at any moment or last for many years. You may never see the results of current work, but you can just as easily see it through and then have to decide what to do next. Perhaps you'll die today, perhaps in 50 years. With such uncertainty, what do you do? In other words, since you can't count on the future, chances are you won't die this instant, how do you live? Suppose that you are a mother home from work in the evening. Do you prepare tomorrow's dinner or not? Suppose that you are a research doctor and you discover a new treatment for arthritis. Do you go about setting up field trials that may take many years to complete? Imagine that you are a contractor and your client refuses to pay you for your work. What do you do? Life is what we experience. The inevitability of death is the ever-present reminder that life is what we experience, not what we own, not what we leave behind us, and not how history views us. The fragility of life reminds us that the present moment of experience is all we have. To be present in life is to experience the present moment. Be present in the moment, and you will know what to do.